Mr. Burnett, and he's coming up mighty, mighty slow. He has a lot of that air supply has been cut off. And Burnett complaining about the thumb to the throat, and I can't say that I really blame him too much. He has taken a lot of punishment here. Hard right hand, another looping right hand that... off the road, man. It is the back of the elbow catching one Dale Burnett, and you can hear him saying that it's all over. Catches him with that elbow once again, coming off the rope. The Boogie Woogie Man crashes down across the chest, goes into a lateral press, hooks the far leg, and scores the pinfall. And so, the Boogie Woogie Man himself scores the pinfall and takes the measure on one Dale Burnett. And so our opening match very quickly goes to Jimmy Valiant. And right now, here's a special word about tonight. NWA Wrestling returns to Columbus, Ohio in the fairgrounds Saturday, November 24th. Match time is 8:30. NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair defends his title against the former champion Tommy Wildfire Rich. It'll be Jimmy Hart's New York Assassins against Ole Anderson and Thunderbolt Patterson. The television champion Bob Roop defends his title against Ronnie Garvin. The Hollywood Blonde face Brad Armstrong and Jimmy Valiant. It'll be Mr. Ito against Jacques Rougeau. Remember, that Saturday, the 24th, in Columbus, Ohio, at the fairgrounds.
This program is brought to you in part by Bubble Yum Bubble Gum. You ought to be having fun, so yum it up with Bubble Yum.
Talking to Sandy Freeman. Get in on the conversation every weeknight at 9 Eastern on CNN. Look for your CNN channel on your cable system.
Today, it's bombs away in the battle for Mississippi on your superstation. Quarterback Ken Austin and the Ole Miss Rebels look to wage aerial warfare. But Mississippi State's Aaron Pearson and company aim to shoot them down. It's an SEC college football rivalry to remember. Today, live at noon Eastern on your superstation.
Well, in just a moment or two, we're going to be seeing the Hollywood Blondes in action. Of course, they would like to regain that National Tag Team Championship, but all I can say with the events that have been happening lately, a lot of things are coming down. So, well, we'll tell you more about that a little bit later on. But
Gordon Sullivan McKee, whatever thing you've been talking about has been a lie, baby. You saw Thunderbolt Patterson hold me, and you saw Ole Anderson hit me and hit me and hit me. Well, let me tell you something, Ole Anderson. You're going to be paid back. Look at my face. My face is still bruised from this. I promise you, Ole Anderson, you and Thunderbolt Patterson, you ain't through with me yet. I'm going to get you if this last thing I do. You
want now, wait just a minute. Just a minute.
They held me 2-on-1.
Wait a minute. You're saying they held you 2-on-1.
I'm saying if you start with your own eyes, then you know they did.
Just stay here. Stay here, Mr. Hart. Let me ask Jim Reeves, our director, a question right now. Jim, is it possible that we could possibly, sometime later in the program, get a replay of that incident that occurred last week? It is. Okay, fine.
I hope you see this. You'll know it was 2-on-1 then.
Right, that's fine.
You'll know it is, and the whole world can see it, but I'm going to get even. I promise you that. I'll get even.
You'll get even, all right. I'll tell you what, now that I've got Jim Reeves' word that we will be able to get a replay of that later on in the program, as quickly as it's ready, I will have Mr. Hart back out here. Right now, though, let's go to the ring and let's wait for that music now for the Hollywood Blondes. Of his outer garment. He's steadily beginning to do so. It'll be the Hollywood Blondes moving out against Frank Lang and Ted Allen. Lang and Allen are indeed a very fine tag team combination. But they're facing the former national tag team champion. And, of course, for the Hollywood Blondes are strictly on that championship trail again now that we do have new national tag team champion. They lock up collar and elbow very quickly. The Golden Boy has Ted Allen into the ropes, and it is the Golden Boy punishing Allen again with knees to the midsection. Reversal by Allen here, and it is the Golden Boy caught in a high, high back shot. Good drop kick. The Golden Boy tags up with Hustler Rip Rogers. Remember, side headlock now by Ted Allen, and he gets the hip lock takedown and keeps the side headlock on Hustler Rip Rogers. The tag is made. Frank Lang moves into the ring, and he's got the side headlock. Built individual makes the tag with Ted Allen. A stocky but tough competitor, and Mr. Rogers catches him in the head as Allen escapes from that. Once again, a hip lock takedown by Allen. Rogers tried to roll him into a pinning combination. Allen upset him on that, however. Again, the tag is made. The Golden Boy moves in. And Allen very quickly gets that side headlock right back on him. Miss Brenda Britton pacing back and forth in front of the ring. And again, I would like to remind all of you folks, if I may, a word of advice, please. It upsets her greatly as she goes into the arenas around the country and you start calling her a flea bag. She really takes umbrage to that comment, so please refrain and desist from calling her a flea bag. It's very upsetting to her. Allen slips away. Rogers complaining to the referee, Nick Patrick. This is a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Is made once again. Lang moves in. Lang at 244 pounds. Excellent definition and muscular contour. Armbar now by Lang. Let's see how Rogers is going to handle this situation. Rogers gets him off the ring rope. Good leapfrog by Lang, and Lang swing over on Hustler Rip Rogers. The Golden Boy is in there, and he catches Frank Lang in that prefrontal lobe and does a lot of damage, rocks him again. Brother, that'll alter your personality in a hurry. Rip Rogers coming up there, and before the count, they manage to double team on Frank Lang. Again, they're double-teaming on Lang. Double body slam, and it is the Golden Boy with a lateral press. Lang powers away from it, however. Beautiful gut-wrench salto by Ted Oates. And I'll tell you something about Oates. You may not like his philosophy, but, brother, he can compete. Again, the tag is made. So the Hollywood Blondes continue to dominate the situation. And it's Rogers catching him that time. Lang went down. Came down on the shoulder and on the hip. Lang is rocked again and just barely holding on. And again, you see the Golden Boy, and he's in the wrong corner. The tag is made. Back of the elbow into the pectoralis majors of Frank Lang. Off the ropes once again. Rolling reverse by Lang. He may have Rogers. He's closer into the rope. Into the rope. Brother, you talk about a beautiful move by Frank Lang. So it looked for a minute like he had Rogers where he wanted him. Rogers made the tag. Gets the Golden Boy in there. And again, Lang powers out before the count. And again, Lang powers out as both the Golden Boy and Hustler Rip Rogers have tried repeatedly to pin this man. Lang has shown that he's made of stern stuff indeed, because he just flatly refuses to be pinned. Lang's head smashed into the turnbuckle. He's dazed and groggy. Those knees are rubbery. He's trying to battle over and make the tag. They double team. And Lang again, now trying to get over there, and it is just to no avail whatsoever, as the Golden Boy brings him up a full body slam again, jarring those 26 vertebrae, then the knee into the chest, the lateral press. Rogers lashes out with a boot into the side of the rib cage. Good move by Lang. Good counter by Lang. Had him to an outside cradle. And Rogers now blocked him as he tried to get over there and make the tag with Ted Allen. And so Lang is steadily being worn down by the Hollywood Blonde. Their strategy appears to be working now as they continue to keep him away from the corner. Lang retaliating on the Golden Boy. And it is Lang trying, and he does. He smashes the Golden Boy's head back in. But notice the way the Golden Boy blocked him. Made the tag with Hustler Rip Rogers. Rogers moves in again. Rogers pounding away. Rabbit punches to the back of the head, the base of the skull of Frank Lang. Again, a snap there that takes him to the canvas. Lang. I'll tell you what. He is really amazing me with his fantastic effort. Great second effort. They have completely blocked him from getting over to his corner. Ted Allen has not been able to do anything whatsoever for Lang for the past many moments. And so it is Lang still continuing to have punishment after punishment heaped upon him. And he cannot get over to make that tag. A critical situation for Frank Lang. And it is the Golden Boy catching Ted Allen, and Allen right out there. Referee Nick Patrick sending it back to his corner. Once again, the tag was made. Lang has still not been able to get over and make the tag. Rogers catches him. Now the flat of the foot, and now the flat of the foot to the side of the jaw. And they have turned this Frank Lang every way but loose. And again, he powers out. Some of the greatest second effort that I've ever seen in a competitor. He has been battered from pillar to post. He has taken unbelievable punishment. And he has not conceded. He has not given up. He ducks to one side, nearly, collapsing through the canvas, trying to get over and make the tag. And Lang just will not concede. This man has intestinal fortitude, the likes of which I have not seen in a long, long time. Hollywood Blonde driving down, and again, Lang is able to roll to one side before the count. And again, the Golden Boy moves in and blocks him before he can get over and make the tag. And it's a desperate situation indeed now for Frank Lang. And the Golden Boy catches him again. Lang doubled up and all but helpless now. And what's keeping this man going absolutely defeats me. I really cannot imagine the amount of punishment that he's taking, and he is still able to move. Again. And Lang makes the tag. Lang makes the tag. And it's Ted Allen in there exploding with a right hand on both Hustler Rip Rogers and Set Allen Jefferson with a high back drop. Allen in for a pinning combination. This is the pin, however. A snap there that has back any. Boy, he drove 230 pounds right into the abdominal wall. But the Golden Boy still had plenty of upper body strength left. Up into those ring ropes. A reversal now. Leapfrog by Allen. Allen caught from behind by Hustler Rip Rogers. Tag was made. Caught him from behind. Scored the pinfall. And so that victory indeed, but a hard-fought victory for Mr. Rip Rogers and the Golden Boy. Well, I see Mr. Hart is back.
You know what, Gordon? I've got my composure back right now, but after all, I was almost put in the hospital permanently by Ollie Anderson and Thunderbolt Patterson. You know, like I said, I sit home and I did a little bit of thinking. And I said, you know, I'm going to get even with these two clowns no matter what it takes. If it takes all the money I've got in the bank, I will get even with them. I promise you this. So, Ollie Anderson, you and Thunderbolt Patterson, you've been a little lucky. You know, you've been able to win a few matches around certain areas. But I might bring my nightmares. I'll bring my dirty white boys in. I might bring the Gilberts. But no, you know what I've done? I've picked the phone up, and I'll call me a couple of guys that I know. And I'm not going to spill the beans today, baby. I'm not going to let you know who they are, because I'm not going to let them train and plan for these two guys. But they are giants. They are big, and they are bad, and they can do a lot of destruction. You know, Ollie Anderson, they sit here and say, feed us anybody you want, Hart. Bring your best on. Well, I promise you this, baby. The two men that you're going to see, when I'm ready to unleash them on you, like I said, baby, you can run, but you can't hide, Ollie Anderson. Thunderbolt Patterson, you can run, but you can't hide. You know, we had him in the ring one time, Thunderbolt, and all the thing I could hear was, feet, don't fail me now. Well, baby, it took two of them to bring down Jimmy Hart. Two men against me. I weigh 159 pounds. Both of them to go weigh 600. I can't hardly talk. I'm so excited.
Well,
like I said, time is running out, Ollie Anderson. You and Thunderbolt, time is running out, and that's a promise, baby.
Mr. Hart, before you leave, I would like to bring something to your attention. I am going to be able to play a replay of what occurred last week, and I'll invite you out when we're ready to have that, and we'll see if it was two on one. Right now, here's a special word about tonight. NWA Wrestling returns to Columbus, Ohio in the fairgrounds Saturday, November 24th. Match time is 8:30. NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair defends his title against the former champion Tommy Wildfire Rick. It'll be Jimmy Hart's New York Assassins against Ollie Anderson and Thunderbolt Patterson. The television champion, Bob Roop, defends his title against Ronnie Garvin. The Hollywood Blonde face Brad Armstrong and Jimmy Valiant. It'll be Mr. Ito against Jacques Rougeau. Remember, that Saturday, the 24th, in Columbus, Ohio, at the fairgrounds.
An expert on the joy of Christmas shopping.
How'd you like to have to pick out a Christmas present for me? You probably think I'm tough to please, right? Give me a break. I'm just like any other guy. I'd be thrilled to get this. A subscription to Sports Illustrated. What guy wouldn't? The writing's great. The photography's great. The number one sports magazine in America, isn't it? And I'll tell you something else about this gift. It keeps coming every week, all year long. Look, for starters, I get this special double issue, the Sportsman of the Year. Then I get a good look at the best part of football season, the college ball game, the NFL playoffs, and the Super Bowl. With Sports Illustrated, I get pro and college basketball. I get baseball. I get hockey, boxing, golf. I even get bobsledding. And yeah, Sports Illustrated gives me tennis. Who is that guy? Listen, anyone who follows any sports at all has got to have Sports Illustrated. So how much is all this going to cost? Don't worry. Sports Illustrated has a special holiday rate. 54 issues for only $38.95. That's more than $13 off the regular subscription rate. You save 63% off the cover price. You won't even get billed till next year. And it's not like you have to go out of your way or anything. Just pick up the phone and call this number. It's toll-free. You don't hassle with crowds. You don't mess with sizes. You don't even have to pick out a card. Sports Illustrated will send you one so you can tell that special someone what's coming. What more could you want? All for only $38.95. And that includes next year's pro and college previews for football and basketball. So call 1-800-541-2400 and give Sports Illustrated for Christmas. It pays to be nice to people.
My pleasure right now to have with me one of the finest national and international karate champions and one of the greatest catch-as-catch-can wrestlers I've seen in a long time, Ron Slinker. Welcome aboard, Ron.
Thank you very much, Gordon. It's a pleasure to be here. You know, I've met many athletes in my life, but here has got to be one of the best groups of all-around athletes I've ever met in my life. And it's a privilege and honor to be here to compete against them. I'd like to say that I have met and done everything I could do in the martial arts, and I've met my goals. Now my goal in professional wrestling is to get a shot at that world title.
Shut up, Ron Slinker. You're like these football players, these ex-basketball players, wanting to get into the true sport of wrestling and telling how tough they are. Me and Mr. Ito can knock you down anytime you get your big mouth in the ring there.
Mr. Baker, I'd like one thing to say to you. Just one thing, okay? I'm a professional athlete. I do all my action in the ring, not with my mouth. And any time you want to get into it.
I want to tell these people, they get to see them people on TV, but Ox Baker is smart and... Ron, will you get out of here? Nobody wants to talk to you anymore. Everybody has to pay to see the fantastic Ox Baker beat people up. And Ron, if you ever get in that ring, I don't care who you were, martial arts champion.
You, Ito, or anybody. It's an open contract.
You notice how scared that man is. He's like a lot of other guys. When they hear the name Ox Baker and they see this fist and I drive it into their heart, they're going to go down. And the gentleman like I am, I do the right thing. I kick him right in the face.
What can I say about Ox Baker? 6'5", 311 pounds, and he does have a devastating heart punch. But what a match that'd be. Ron Slinker, martial arts expert, catch-as-catch-can wrestler. That would be something. Let's go to the ring, huh? There you see him, Iron Mike Sharp. And he's moving out against Mike Starbuck. Sharp charges him. Starbuck ducks away. Starbuck ducks away once again. And Sharp complaining. He wants to meet him head on, and I can't blame him, but Starbuck realizes a head-on confrontation is possibly going to lead to a lot of problems because Sharp does hold a height and weight advantage on him. He misses again. So Starbuck has been really dazzling Mr. Sharp with his footwork, that's for sure. Remember this match, one fall, 10-minute time limit, Iron Mike Sharp. Out of Canada. Brother, he is big, he is powerful, has participated in just about every sport imaginable, including, if I remember correctly, the Canadian National Amateur Boxing Champion. Sharp for the side headlock. Sharp noticing the way and the referee Scrappy McGowan calling the shot on that one and admonishing Iron Mike Sharp. Sharp driving Starbuck's head into the turnbuckle, drives it in once again. And so Mr. Starbuck has taken a lot of punishment in that corner. Good block by Starbuck, and it's Starbuck retaliating. Starbuck staggers Sharp, catches him with a right, then a forearm, another forearm, and Sharp has been, he's been shaken up. Ooh, brother, as he charged him that time, Sharp drove that knee into the chest of Mike Starbuck. And a forearm across the back of Starbuck. Oh! Could hear that one all the way across the television sports arena. Starbuck in a lot of trouble now. He's got him up over those turnbuckles. A clubbing forearm into the chest. And Starbuck has got himself a load of problems here. Starbuck trying to get back through those ropes. Iron Mike Sharp catches him another clubbing forearm across the back. Starbuck down and in a lot of trouble as Iron Mike Sharp has completely dominated the situation, except for one brief flurry by Starbuck. And Sharp goes down that time. It was Starbuck again. Moving to one side, and Starbuck tried to set him for a backdrop, and Iron Mike Sharp was a step ahead of him. Off the ropes. Oh. Well, a forearm lariat is exactly what he did with a side lateral press. And that scores the pinfall. And so Iron Mike Sharp is indeed the victor here over one Mike Starbuck. And we can see an argument ensuing there with the referee. Want to take a second right now to talk to Brad Armstrong. A lot of things have been happening in the past week or so. And, well, it's before we talk to Brad, let's take a look at what's going on here at the ring. As Iron Mike Starbuck was just hurdled from the ring by Mike Starbuck. Let me talk to Brad Armstrong. Thank you for giving Mike Starbuck a helping hand, sir.
Well, it looks like he needed it. People like that is disgusting to me, to see somebody abuse somebody like that. And something else has disgusted me is these long riders. And you've seen them wrestle. I know the people have seen them, and they've already made their move. They tried to hurt a few people. Well, it's time we made our move, and I'm talking about Tommy Rich and myself, and we're not backing down one bit. I know the long riders are big men, but wherever we can get them, we're going to take them.
Thank you so very much, Brad Armstrong. And right now, here's a very special word.
It's NWA Wrestling tonight in Columbus, Ohio at the fairgrounds. Match time is 8 p.m. On the 30th in Vidalia, Georgia, at the Tripp High School Gymnasium. Match time there, 8:30. And on Tuesday the 4th in Baltimore, Maryland, at the Civic Center, match time 8 p.m. On the 5th in Athens, Ohio, the Athens High School Gymnasium. On the 6th in Charleston, West Virginia, at the Civic Center. And on Friday the 7th in Cleveland, Ohio, at the Convention Center, match time is 8 p.m. We'll see you. Go with the best, the NWA.
Those terrific tummies. They have no idea what some tummies are put through. From bending and binding, shaking and shifting, just to make them flat. Introducing the new Belly Burner. It can flatten your stomach. Although it looks easy, it isn't. But it works and strengthens your lower back. Order your Belly Burner today, and we'll include Jim Everroad's bestseller, How to Flatten Your Stomach.
I'm convinced this system is the best and quickest way to flatten your stomach. Now, if you don't agree, return it, and I'll return your money.
The Belly Burner, only $19.95 during this limited TV offer. It's patented, proven, and it works beautifully.
VOD and credit card orders, call toll-free 1-800-257-1234. In New Jersey, call 800-232-6966. Or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $3 for shipping and handling to The Belly Burner, Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30306.
All right, I'll tell you what we're going to do right now. We heard Brad Armstrong talking about the Long Riders. Well, they are indeed an impressive and powerful tag team combination. We're going to pick up the closing moments of a match with the Long Riders. So let's take a look at this most impressive tag team in action right now. Let's join it in progress.
Back from left field. Iceman, though, still in lots of trouble. But the Hard misses. And Iceman rolls it over, and here comes Zumhoff, who steps right into a blow, and it fights back. Takes care of everybody. Irwin, Wild Bill is in. There's Hogg. That's the official contest. Hogg and Wild Bill, Irwin, Zumhoff, and the Iceman battling it out in the main event of World Class Championship Wrestling. Now Hogg has Zumhoff in trouble. They're going to hold him up. And Zumhoff slips underneath. Irwin hits Irwin. Hogg smashed Wild Bill. But Zumhoff is garroted. One, two, three. And it is the Irwin over Iceman and King Parsons. Hogg getting the pin. Well, let's go to Mark Clement.
8 minutes, 16 seconds. There are the title holders, the Irwin brothers.
I want to take a moment right now to talk to the national heavyweight champion, the man with the hands of stone, Ronnie Garvin. Obviously, that is just one notch below the World Heavyweight Championship.
That's right, Gordon. I feel like I'm one step below, and I'm going to take that final step when I meet Ric Flair. And I'm going to tell you, Ric Flair, I've been after you for a long time in the best conditions I've ever been in all my life. And there's a lot of people after my title. Walt McDaniel is one of them, Ox Baker, and then you got Art's family. Well, I'm not a closet champion. You know that, Gordon.
Right.
I'll defend my title against anybody. I got an open contract. Anybody wants to put it on the dotted line, just go ahead. You can knock on my door, and I'll open it anytime.
I think an interesting thing about professional wrestling, too, is it's a sport that you mature into. It's not like in football or in baseball where the older you get, the slower you get, and the more out of the picture you get. I think the more you mature in this sport, the better your chances of picking up that title.
You're right, Gordon. You're absolutely right. You know, it's a one-on-one. Supposedly, a few times, it would be two or three-on-one, but it's supposed to be one-on-one, and competition is tough, and I think the more you mature when you get in your 30s, and I think you got a much better chance because I think all the training and the experience is very important.
Certainly no question about that, and it's been our pleasure to have with us right now the national heavyweight champion. And may I just say that we certainly hope that one day in the very, very near future, perhaps when we bring him on the air, we'll be introducing him as Ronnie Garvin, the NWA World Heavyweight Champion. Good luck, my
friend. Thank you, Gordon. Thank you.
Ronnie Garvin, tremendous athlete and a tremendous competitor. We've got two great athletes in the ring right now, so let's go to the squared circle. Bob Roop, the national television champion. And, of course, that title is automatically on the line. This match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. He's going up against Roger Bond. And it's Roof very quickly trying to take... Ooh, brother. Bond driven into those ropes, and Roof brings him up. Referee Nick Patrick warning Roop about the tactics that he's already started using. And Roop explodes with a, really a right cross to the side of the jaw of one Roger Bond, and then the elbow to the base of the skull. You jar that brain enough, it'll short circuit out. And it is Roop coming down across those femoris muscles of Roger Bond. Roop, of course, who was in the Olympics. He was a Greco-Roman expert, but he is an all-around catch-as-catch-can wrestler, all-Army champion. Holds a great weight advantage on Roger Bond. And Roop brings him over to the far turnbuckle. And Nick Patrick warning Roop to let Bond get off those ropes, and Roop continues to drive the flat of the foot into the abdominal wall. Bond fires to the midsection, fires again. Those punches are ineffectual, to say the least. Making the comment, where are all the tough guys? Well, he is one of them. There's no question about it. He's another fellow that's out after Ronnie Garvin. Garvin's out after him just as well. I, for one, would like to see the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant, move out against this man, Bob Roop. I think that'll be a classic match. You've got the excitement, the electricity of a Jimmy Valiant, and you've got the... exceptionally dangerous, almost a Sherman tank approach of one Bob Roop. He is heavy artillery. There's no question about it. Roop again, a clubbing right hand to the side of the jaw of Roger Bond. And Bond now having problems getting to his feet. He has been staggered and dazed rather badly. Again, Roop driving through the midsection again, catches him. And so it is Bob Roop dominating the situation with Roger Bond. Bond. And Roop now, I think, has this man exactly where he wants him. could basically do anything he wants to, but I think now he is just trying to punish Bond. I think he realizes that he is not in danger of the bottom wrist lock. And so Bond in a lot of trouble. Roop could very easily go to a lateral drop here if he wished. Bond trying desperately to move away from this, and he's being punished. Bond has just nowhere to go and no way to get there. Tried again to bring him up for a slam and just could not do it. Roop had him outgunned. Here's a situation of, there's so many times talk about the battle between the good little man and the good big man. And invariably, in that case, the good big man is going to win. And there you see it, exactly what I'm talking about with Bob Roop. He's got that sadistic streak. Went ahead, could have had him for the pinning combination there. Wanted to punish him some more, brought him up, didn't allow the count. And again, doesn't allow the count. He's liable to find himself in a disqualification mode here momentarily. Roop brings him up. There's the shoulder snap, shoulder breaker. Now the lateral press. And that does indeed score the pinfall. And so Mr. Roop, well, he wanted a double count. And so as you can see, a very proud, a vainglorious man, if you will, Bob Roop, the national television champion, is the victor. Joining me here at the podium now are the former national tag team champions, the Hollywood Blondes.
Yes, that's right, Gordon Sully. But you see that Bob Roop in that ring? He looks so tough. But when you're talking about the Hollywood Blondes, you're talking about the hustle, the golden boy, the personal valet, Miss Brenda Britton. You're talking about the premier tag team of all professional wrestling today. You're talking about the team with unlimited zeal and Texas sex appeal. You're talking about the baddest team in professional wrestling today. And we're challenging anybody and everybody. Come on down and face us, because we're the baddest guys and the prettiest here.
Well, indeed.
We're going to get our belts back.
Well, we'll find out about that.
After that, any doubt in anybody's mind who the world television champion is? Well, there's no doubt in mine. There's no doubt in Garvin's, because he's tried. There's no doubt at all in Brad Armstrong, because he's tried. But maybe there's one or two of you people out there that think I can be beat. Maybe you'll be wrestlers. Let me tell you something. Talk to Garvin. Talk to Armstrong. Talk to Pigface. They'll tell you. Roop cannot be beat.
It's NWA Wrestling tonight in Columbus, Ohio at the fairgrounds. Match time is 8 p.m. On the 30th in Vidalia, Georgia at the Tripp High School Gymnasium. Match time there, 8:30. And on Tuesday the 4th in Baltimore, Maryland at the Civic Center. Match time, 8 p.m. On the 5th in Athens, Ohio, the Athens High School Gymnasium. On the 6th in Charleston, West Virginia at the Civic Center. And on Friday the 7th in Cleveland, Ohio at the Convention Center. Match time is 8 p.m. We'll see you. Go with the best, the NWA.
Okay, and it is tonight, of course, in Columbus, Ohio, at the fairgrounds. Match time is 8:30. NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair defending his title against Tommy Wildfire Rich, and what a match that's going to be. Ole Anderson and Thunderbolt Patterson take on the New York Assassins. And they're, of course, Jimmy Hart's man.
See, I'm finna start traveling.
Mm-hmm.
On tour. I mean, I'm going all over. You know, it's real good to be back, and it all is happening right here from Georgia.
This famous star's piano music is so irresistibly beautiful, a single one of his recordings sold over 1 million copies. Floyd Kramer is so popular that there are over 50 RCA albums of his music. For the first time, you can enjoy beautiful Floyd Kramer recordings never released in any album before. The most beautiful piano recordings you've ever heard. Songs you always loved. Every recording richly orchestrated. Also get another entire Floyd Kramer album. A treasury of all-time favorites. listening to this beautiful treasury of favorites and how you'll enjoy the world-famous love song. You get both exclusive Floyd Kramer treasuries. This offer is not in stores. Order yours now.
Use your MasterCard or Visa. Call toll-free 1-800-257-1234. That's 1-800-257-1234. You get two records, two 8-track tapes, or two cassettes. To save handling and COD charges, send only $12.98 to Floyd Kramer, Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357. Or call toll-free 1-800-257-1234.
You know, there are literally thousands and thousands of missing children throughout the entire length and breadth of our United States. Each week here on Championship Wrestling from Georgia, we try to bring you two children who are missing and trying to gain information about them. Our first one this week is Bobby Dwayne Kelly. Bobby Dwayne Kelly, he's a 16-year-old. He was last seen August 31st, 1984, on Tyndall Air Force Base in Panama City, Florida. Anyone having any information about this young man in Florida, call 1-800-342-0821. Outside of Florida, call 904-488-5221 or contact your local sheriff's department. Either of those two numbers or contact your local sheriff's department. Our second missing youngster is Willie Virgilie Lawson. Willie is a 14-year-old white female. She was last seen September 17th, 1984 in Lakeland, Florida. She was in the company of Joanne Kessler, a 14-year-old white female. They may be in the vicinity of Lawrenceburg, Tennessee, Pedro, Ohio, or possibly somewhere in Florida. Again, if you have any information in Florida, dial 1-800-342-0821. Outside of Florida, 904-488-5221, or contact your local sheriff's department. We sincerely appreciate your cooperation in this matter. Right now, let's go to the ring for our next match. There you see him. Jerry the King Lawler, ready to go. One fall, 10-minute time limit. He's going up against Lee Ramsey. Ramsey charges right in and bowls the King right back to the turnbuckle. Uh-oh. Ramsey. A little open-handed slap on the break. Ramsey must feel pretty doggone confident. And a bit of bravado there, probably trying to show Mr. Lawler that he's heard about his reputation and is awed by it. And that Mr. Lawler's going to have to come and get it if he wants it. And again, Ramsey with just a little insulting slap. Not designed to hurt, just designed to humiliate, embarrass. And perhaps to get Lawler. Oh, Lawler just let fly with a right hand. The heck with the open hand. Let's give him a little knuckle sandwich. And that's what he did. I don't know if Mr. Ramsey's aware of it or not, but Mr. Lawler will go to Fifth City right now. He's got a handy pair of dukes. Interesting man, Jerry Lawler. Very talented artist. Has a sensitive nature that a lot of people I don't think are aware of. He spends a lot of time doing a lot of good for a lot of people. Very interested in the youth of America. Ramsey trying to get him over into a pinning combination. Lawler just hangs in with that side headlock.
One, two, three.
Nice call for the break. On the break, it was Ramsey with a set-up right hand, and Lawler saw it coming, hung onto those ring ropes, and so Ramsey was frustrated again. Mr. Ramsey suddenly found himself airborne, got into a high backdrop. Lawler, and his rip punch again, tried to hook him into a rolling reverse. Tried to hook him in a rolling reverse from a leapfrog. Lawler upended that and brings him into a full body slam. Lawler has slapped, stayed ahead of his man. Ramsey managed to get a shoulder off. By the King into a rear chin lock. All right, Lawler keeping the rear chin lock. Ramsey, as long as the way Lawler's got it, too, he's well over the chin, so consequently, the referee doesn't have to worry about a possible choke. Fires him off the rope. That time it was Ramsey catching him very nicely in that rolling reverse, but Lawler has the strategy of his own going, and Ramsey caught with a hard right hand. So Lawler, beginning to tire of some of the tactics of one Mr. Ramsey. Wow. Drove a foot into the side of the head of Ramsey. High vertical souplé by Jerry Lawler. Ramsey had those 26 vertebrae jarred that time. Tell you what, Ramsey's got good second effort. A two count. Ooh, brother. Lawler caught and staggered by that one. Well, he's knocking Lawler right back to the state of Idaho, I'll tell you that. And Lawler being rocked and rolled now. Caught one on the nose that time, and Ramsey has Lawler on the canvas and for the... And Ramsey again. And a little slap across the face. Insolence at its height. And wait a minute. Lawler starts to salt. And now it's Lawler exploding. I told you he'd go to Fist City. And he just did it. Mr. Ramsey drops with a couple of them down across the head. Count of three. Jerry the King Lawler. And Mr. Ramsey got a quick lesson in what it's all about if you want to go to a Pier Sixer with Jerry the King Lawler. Let me bring in the Boogie Woogie Man himself, Luscious Jimmy Van.
Mercy, you sure got that right, baby. I'll say all my people, all my brothers, sisters. Did you see my main man, Jared the King Lala? You know, I love him to death, baby. I love him to death. You know, I trust a man. I can turn my back on a man. You know, I'll even give him my old lady. You know, I think my old lady's for the ghost form, too, you understand? Jerry, Kingfish, come in here. You know, hey, Jerry, I'm going to ask you a question. You don't swap around or nothing. No. Don't say nothing like that. You know something? I love this man to death. And anywhere, any place, people, Jerry the King Lala. I call him Kingfish, you see. Jerry Kingfish Lala. And the Boogie Woogie Man, Handsome Jim, man. He's too much to take on one break.
He set a mouthful, I guarantee you, Gordon. I love this guy. He's the greatest partner that I've ever had. I look forward to the competition in this area as long as I got him in my corner. But I'm going to let him keep his old ladies, okay?
By all means, I know.
Six of them, you know.
You what? Mr. Ramsey decided he wanted to go to Fifth City, whether he found out that's a mistake.
Well, Ramsey got a pretty decent little punch there, you know. He kind of surprised me, but as I told these people before, I got a pretty good right hand, not too bad of a left. If they want to duke it out, brother, I'm ready anytime.
Well, I made the mention at the time. I said it looked like me. He put you back in the state of Idaho for a moment.
Yeah, he had a couple of good shots there, but I think I returned the favor, Gordon.
I think you did indeed. There's always payback time, and receipts are due. Right now, here's a very, very special word.
Grandma, our daddy's coming home.
It's NWA Wrestling tonight in Columbus, Ohio at the fairgrounds. Match time is 8 p.m. On the 30th in Vidalia, Georgia, at the Tripp High School Gymnasium. Match time there, 8:30. And on Tuesday the 4th in Baltimore, Maryland, at the Civic Center. Match time, 8 p.m. On the 5th in Athens, Ohio, the Athens High School Gymnasium. On the 6th in Charleston, West Virginia, at the Civic Center. And on Friday the 7th in Cleveland, Ohio, at the Convention Center. Match time is 8 p.m. We'll see you. Go with the best, the NWA.
Take control. Own your favorite hit videos on Sony Video 45. Videos you own. Just $16.95. Call toll-free now for your own Duran Duran Video 45. Get hungry like the wolf. Plus a full-length, uncut Girls on Film. Use your credit card. Call now for your own David Bowie Video 45. Experience modern love. Let's Dance. Plus the uncensored China Girl. Check out the Phil Collins Video 45. Four great videos, including In the Air Tonight and I Missed Again. And bring home your own Sheena Easton Video 45. Use your telephone. Catch the morning train, telephone, and more. Select your favorite videos on Sony Video 45 by Duran Duran, David Bowie, Phil Collins, Sheena Easton, and dozens more. Music for your eyes.
Beta Hi-Fi or VHS stereo, just $16.95 each. Call 1-800-257-1234 now.
Let me check with my director, Jim Reed. Jim, is that VTR ready? Okay, fine. Mr. Hart, would you come over here, please?
Good. I want you, everybody, the millions of people out there to see these two guys attack me right here on national TV. Good. Roll this film.
Now, just a moment. Just a moment before we roll it. I'd just like to say that I think you owe everybody an apology.
An apology?
If in fact, Thunderbolt Patterson was not holding you. Let's take a look now. Let's go back 1 week to the situation that Mr. Hart claimed to attack him.
Let me tell you something, Ole Anderson. This is 1984, not 1954, baby. This is the future of professional wrestling. I can bring anybody, any place, anywhere in here that can whip you and this man right here. Look at him, all dressed up with no place to go. Both of you are, man.
You know, there's only one thing I can say when I look at you. I get so a little bit disgusted. I listen.
You want to hit me, don't you? I guess you want to knock this chip off my shoulder. Don't you, Ole Anderson?
No, but I would like to take you.
Uh-oh. He's offering to take him in the ring. And Ole Anderson.
You know, you go ahead in the wrestling ring.
I'll sue you.
Hang up there. Shut up for about 5 seconds. Shut up and don't say a word.
Ain't now one of you on
the. You take the wrestler and you go ahead and you throw him in the ring and you wrestle him. But when you got a little weasel like Jimmy Hart, you don't worry about wrestling. You got to give him a message. You got to give him a message that you can take back to your people. Right?
And so you get the camera right over here. Get your sword up.
Wow, brother. Wow. Open-handed slap. And
I said, there's only one thing you can do. You maybe go ahead and insult him. Get him a little bit upset. Get him a little excited. Because I'm excited. And I'll be there. If anybody's going to get in there and try to tell me they're going to run me off or they're going to run Thunderbolt off or anybody else off, I don't care if you're from New York. I don't care if you're from Chicago. I don't care where you're from. The people right here aren't going to stand for it. And I sure as hell am not going to. And he's not going to. So you get your stuff together. You come on and get us.
All right.
All right, there it is.
See, it took two of them. You saw Thunderbolt holding my feet right there. They didn't get a camera shot. Thunderbolt was holding my feet the whole time where I couldn't do anything. I couldn't kick him. I couldn't do anything. But listen, let me tell you. Come here, Abdullah the Butcher. Abdullah the Butcher, from now on, everywhere I go, I'm going to have me a bodyguard. Like I said, Ole Anderson, in this briefcase, baby, I've got two men's names. They are big and they are bad. And when the time's right, I'm going to unleash them on you and Thunderbolt Patterson. It was two of them holding my feet, baby.
Would you care to apologize, sir?
Apologizing to anybody. If I had my karate belt on, they wouldn't have done it to me. But from now on, I'm gonna pay them back, and that's a promise. It took two of them to jump me, not one but two. The camera didn't pick up Thunderbolt Patterson holding my feet, and you know it, Gordon.
Brother, you talk about a patent prevaricator. That man is indeed. He has a marked propensity for prevarication. Well, the assassin and Abdullah the Butcher moving out against Darren Smith and Terry Ellis. One fall, television time remaining, and brothers, they made short work of dropping those two out of the ring.
This is what's going to be like from now on, baby. Whenever you get anybody in the first family, like I said, I have a lot of money and I have a lot of connections. Ole Anderson, you and Thunderbolt Patterson will never lay a hand on me again, and that's a promise.
Well, all right, it's Abdullah the Butcher now. That's Terry Ellis back in the ring, and it's Abdullah the Butcher. Wow, caught him with a shoulder smash, drove him back into the ropes. Terry Ellis in a lot of trouble. Another headbutt that puts Ellis back to the canvas. Darren Smith outside the ring. So it's the assassin and Abdullah the Butcher. Another headbutt by Abdullah the Butcher. Abdullah the Butcher, the wild man from the Sudan. Over 400 pounds, and brother, he is just as mean as he is big. Now the assassin moves in, and he is a very thorough competitor. High backdrop on Ellis.
Where's Thunderbolt now? Where's Ole Anderson now? Where's Valiant? Where's Lawler? Where's everybody? Bring Brad Armstrong. Brad, hang some paper on, baby. Garvin. Like I said before, baby, I'm here to stay. I'm not going to be playing around out here, baby. I've got money. I've got connections. I've got everything. Gordon Sully, I promise you, you tried my patience today. You really tried my patience. And last week, you didn't even jump in to help me. 2-on-1, and what did you do? You stood over here hiding behind this desk. It's never going to happen to me again, and that's a promise. Mark my words on it. That's a promise.
My position, Mr. Hart, is an impartial observer. I'm not sure Mr. Hart would understand what I said, but nonetheless, Ellis makes the tag now with Darren Smith. Darren Smith moving in against a very formidable individual. an awesome man, Abdullah the Butcher. And again, Abdullah the Butcher puts Darren Smith back to the canvas. He has caught him several times in the throat, now makes the tag with the assassin. Assassin moves in, uses the back of the elbow very effectively. Assassin brings him up. Backbreaker. Brings him back up once again. Makes the tag with Abdullah the Butcher. Drops him to the canvas. He's got him trapped. The count is on. Ooh. Oh, 100 pounds crashing down on Darren Smith. Doesn't allow the pin. The man obviously is beaten. And it's Abdullah the Butcher. Again, crashing down into the throat and the head of Darren Smith. It's all over. It is all over. No opportunity at all for Darren Smith there. And joining me here at the podium in the closing seconds of this hour of championship wrestling from Georgia, the team of Ole Anderson and Thunderbolt Patterson, and they're on the move.
I'll tell you, I got my shirt sleeves rolled up and I got my tie a little bit loose. Maybe I could put it around Jimmy Hart's neck. But Thunderbolt Patterson and I are going to do something that's never been done. You always look for a guy to run on law and order. You always like somebody that can stand up for what's right. Well, if this guy and myself can't do what's right, then as far as I'm concerned, nobody can. Bolt, tell him.
It is.
You know, it's coming, and it's coming down now. You can bring anybody that you want. It's a whole new day, and all I know is that Ole and I are together. And that's all I've ever asked it, and we're going to do it.
Next week, so long.